Hi everyone! In this video, I would like to show you how I made a customizable DIY IR intervalometer. An IR intervalometer is a device that repeatedly sends an IR signal to a camera after some predefined time interval. It's very useful for creating time lapses or for taking pictures after a set delay. Let's go back in time about half a year. I bought this camera on a site similar to eBay, and despite being a 5-year-old at the time, this camera looks like new and didn't see much usage. Good for taking still photos and video up to 1080p. Unfortunately, no 4K and time-lapse. Today, most of the smartphones have a time-lapse function, and I'm surprised that it wasn't a thing 5 years ago. Anyway, we'll fix it. It is time to take something apart. I'll need an infrared LED from this old remote to send a signal for my camera. And here is our thingy, built on a breadboard. I've just connected an OLED display to Arduino Nano, added an IR LED to pin 7 and two buttons to pins 4 and 5, a few resistors, and that's all we need. Here, look at this diagram. And here is a very simple program that I wrote for this device. Don't forget to install these libraries in the Arduino IDE. Also, check what is the I2C address of your OLED display. Most of the time it's written on the bottom side of the PCB. You can change the address in software or by replacing the resistor. You can find all the links in the description below this video, including schematics, code and useful links. This piece of code responsible for creating an infrared signal I found in the blog post on the internet. It should be compatible with most Canon cameras. I connected Arduino Nano to my laptop and as you can see the program is uploading. And it's alive! You can scroll down the menu with the right button and to select you press the left button. I've installed a white LED for debugging purposes. You can see when I press a button it blinks very quickly. And if I swap it with an infrared LED, I can't see it flashing and neither my camera. Of course, it's not very convenient to use it as is on a breadboard, so I've soldered everything to a 7x5cm perfboard. Also, I've added an external switch to power up and power down this device, a barrel jack to power this thing from an external power supply, and a screw terminal connected in parallel to a select button. So, if you point it at Trigger Now menu, you can activate it with an external switch by shorting these screw terminals. For example, you can attach it to an end stop on a 3D printer and take a photo after every layer. It's quite a useful feature. I have bought an IC adapter with ADC coupler recently and attached two wires in parallel to the output of an AC adapter and also added a barrel jack at the end. Now I can power my camera and my remote slash intervalometer from the same AC adapter. I've measured power consumption of an Arduino and it's draining only 20-25 mA. It should be good. And, of course, I 3D printed an enclosure for this device. This is a bottom piece. And this is a top piece. I've hot glued a piece of clear polyethylene to it as a protection for the OLED screen. And this red button's cute. Here I screw everything together using M2 screws, which are 16mm long and corresponding nuts. There is one caveat. To keep it simple, stupid, I have written the program using delay and not minus. It means that it's a blocking code and you can't interrupt it while it's running in the loop for intervalometer functions. So I have to power down and power up the device. But it's not a bug, it's a feature. While my camera takes photos every minute or so, nobody can mess with my setting without resetting the device. Let's summarize. Here I insert a DC coupler and connect it to an AC adapter. These DC couplers are very simple devices. You can make one from a dead battery, they already have PCB with contact pads, and you just need to remove a battery and glue a barrel jack at the bottom. Next, I plug in the intervalometer. Enable remote control function on my camera. And point the remote to my camera. I select an option to take a picture every 5 seconds. Don't forget to turn manual focus on, or your camera may try to focus on nearby objects before taking pictures. Now I reset the device and choose an option to take a shot after 5 seconds. And now I'm using it as a simple remote. Also, I can attach an external switch to screw terminals and trigger this device from another switch. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.